safety. Everyone is given a certain thing and say, oh, these are stem cells, you can infuse it by IV or you can inject IM, but are they really stem cells or are they just cells? So how are you going to prove they are stem cells or they are live cells? Or they may not even be the live cells, they could be the exosomes of the secretones, which are the secretions of the cells, okay? Or the stem cells. Again, it could be just the organelles or the component, the extracts of the cells. So how do we measure all this? Now, this is another stage where you have to be very careful. You know, a lot of physicians are buying it from the promoters or the providers, but they may not be aware that they may not be stem cells in it, okay? So this is where the lab had to come in. They had to do some testing. You need some testing to go through all this. You probably need a fluorescent microscope to test what type of cells they are with different CD markers, biomarkers to test, you know, if they are mesenchymal cells. Again, from the mesenchymal cells, what is the cell count? The cell count matters too, okay? And what about the viability of the cells, the percentage of live cells in that count? If the viability is very low, that means the cell count, even with a high, will become very low. But if the cell count is low and viability is low, probably you don't even have the stem cells. So the quality of the cells matters very much, apart from the quantity of the cells. Next, the segregations of the cells. Stem cells, mesenchymal stem cells, mesenchymal cells, pancreatic stem cells, pancreatic cells, pancreatic extracts. There's a lot of difference. So when you talk in terms of potency, the potency, the stem cells will be much more potent than the live cells. And again, the live cells or the stem cells will be much potent than the exosomes or the components of the cells or the extracts of the cells. Why? Because in the cells, you have all the components. You even have the exosomes. All cells secrete the exosomes. So that is important to understand. If someone were to tell me that exosomes are stronger than the stem cells or the live cells, no, I don't think so. Because the cells itself is secreting all the exosomes all the time. There's exosomes even in our blood and urine. Okay, so it depends what type of exosomes, what type of cells, what types of stem cells you have to treat the patient. We have to understand the principle of similia similibus curanto. That means like treats like. That is important. You need an eye for an eye problem. You need a brain for a brain problem. Again, in the brain, what type of brain cells you're going to give for a specific brain disorder patient. So again, with the diabetes type 2, like I say, you need the islets of the Langerhans to treat diabetes and not just to give the pancreatic cells alone. If you give the specific cells found in the pancreas, that will even work better. Same for the heart, you give the cardiomyocyte. Same for the kidney, you give the renal cells to treat kidney patients. It will not be feasible to use placental cells or mesenchymal cells or liver cells to treat kidney patients. What is needed in the kidney is a dysfunction of the kidney cells, of the kidney organs. So you probably give the kidney cells. So this is what we must understand. They must be target organ-specific cells for targeted problem. If you want the best result, this will be. We have tried all kinds of cells. We have tried the human. We tried autologous and allogenic. We all tried the xenogenic. My point is the important point which I always tell to all our physicians, where we also have in our clinic, we have 22 clinics across the world, clinic and hospital. We always say that what matters more? Safety. First, do no harm. Premium non nocere. We must not have any harm, and safetiness is most important. Secondly, potency. It's no point to give something which don't work for the patient. We do not want the patient to pay us money and it don't work at all. So if we cannot take up the case and we sincerely think it won't work for the patient, we rather not treat the patient because we don't want to waste our time and their money too. So if we have to treat a patient, we must always treat with the heart. Stem cells will be one of the best ways to treat patients. But when it comes to cancer patients, I will not use stem cells to treat cancer patients first. I will increase the immune system of the patient first, so that when the immune system goes up, the cancer cell will be suppressed. So this is where immunology will come in. There's some form of treatments with immunology. But of course, you can still go along with the thymus cells to boost up the immune system or the transfer factors, you know, to boost up the immune system of a patient. So I hope my message across here to the physicians that we must understand there are many types of stem cells. I would say mesenchymal cells most of the time will do stimulation. Okay, if you want to repair, use the target specific cells. Use the mesenchymal cells in combination with the organ specific cells. That will work and it will work much better. If you were to use a xenogenic and you use the allogenic and the autologous, they probably synergize each other and work even better. Okay, it's for example, you have a kidney patient, stage 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and that patient in stage 5 is probably under dialysis. You probably have to give the renal cells for the regeneration. You cannot just give mesenchymal cells. I sincerely think that way. Thank you. Thank you.